Hello, this is Pastor Dewey Miller coming to you again with the next in our series of videos on Lent. Today's study, today's teaching will be especially concerning Good Friday, the Friday in which Jesus was crucified. Well, let's remember, first of all, that it's the day we remember it as well as celebrate the crucifixion of Jesus. It's hard for us sometimes to consider that a day can be good in which our Lord was murdered, but because we know the implications and the ramifications of what happened on Good Friday, we can be excited and celebrate the gift, the sacrifice that Jesus made on our behalf. Here's what happened on Good Friday. First of all, Jesus had been arrested on Thursday. On Friday, he faced trial. Trial, first of all, before the Sanhedrin, the Jewish leaders, the religious leaders of the day. And then there was a trial before Herod and two trials before Pilate. In all of those, Jesus proved to us not to be guilty, but faced charges, trumped up charges over and over again. He was stripped and beaten. He took 40 lashes from the flagellum that was used by the Romans at that time. He was given a crown made of thorns that was thrust down upon his scalp. He was made to carry his own cross. He was nailed to the cross, and then it was raised up and dropped into the hole that had been prepared for it. He was ultimately pierced, stabbed with a spear into his side, which punctured his heart, and finally he died. His body was removed from the cross and then buried before sunset. An interesting thing is that it was Joseph of Arimathea, a member of the Jewish leadership, who took Jesus' body and buried it because of his concern of doing the right thing to get Jesus buried before the beginning of the Passover Sabbath. And then after the crucifixion, the disciples, those who were Jesus' closest friends and most committed followers, scattered all over Jerusalem and Judea, all over Palestine at that time. Well, I mentioned earlier that Good Friday is considered good, and I'm going to stand by that. I think it's good because Jesus became the sacrifice for our sins. You remember during the Old Testament times, during those times when the people lived under the law of the Old Testament, the Mosaic law, there was a strict system of sacrifice, animal sacrifice, that had to be made regularly for the shedding of blood so people could be forgiven their sins. However, Jesus' sacrifice displaced all of that. He became our sacrifice once for all. So that makes Good Friday good. Another thing that makes Good Friday good is that Jesus' death is the fulfillment of God's plan. All throughout the scripture, we see the prophecies and promises that lead up to the coming of Jesus and ultimately to his sacrifice, to his gift to us. It's a fulfillment when we see Jesus doing what God sent him to earth to do, what Jesus himself came to earth to do. It fulfills God's promise to us. Well, God's promises to us are that he never leaves us, that his sacrifice is for us, and that if he's crucified, if he dies, he'll be raised again. You'll want to be sure and check out the next video in this series as we talk about Easter, when the ultimate promise is fulfilled. Thanks for joining us.